We're in part three, or is this part four, of our Gar's Hour of Power today. Went a little bit long, had a lot to say. So we're talking about standing by me. You stand by me and I'll stand by you. We are the messengers of truth, justice, compassion, honesty, humility, humbleness. No more bigotry. No more racism. No more exclusionism. No more because you're gay, you're out. Because you're fat, you're out. No, if you're gay, you're in. If you're straight, you're in. If you're thin, you're in. Thin is in, fat is in. Young is in, old is in. If you're old and if you're 65 years old, you get fired now because you're 65 and they want to hire somebody 25 and they pay him half the rate? No, it's not fair. A human life is so valuable. Why screw up that guy? Now he's got a family. Now he's got to go. He's not going to find an easy job at 65 years old. Now he's got to go. His three kids and they're still in school. What do you do? You just produce potential homelessness. The homelessness is not good for the country. It's not good for us. The homelessness creates more taxes for us because we got to pay more. The government wants to charge us more now because we got to support the homeless people. So don't fire the guy because he's 65. Don't fire him. Don't not give him a job because he speaks a broken English. Give him a chance. My Irish brothers in the 1800s got a chance. My Italian brothers and sisters got a chance in the late 1900s. My Jewish brothers and sisters got a chance in the early 20th century and in the 1930s. So give the Islamic people a chance. Give the Latino, the Mexicans, the Guatemalans, the Nicaraguans, the Hondurans, the Colombians, give them a chance. You had a chance. Your parents had a chance. Your ancestors had a chance. Give them the chance that your ancestors had. Don't walk around with a silver spoon in your mouth because you forgot where your roots are. You are the messenger of truth, justice, compassion, and the American way, as they used to say in Superman when I was a kid. Truth, justice, and the American way. Believe in it. Feel it. Think it. Taste it. Hear it. See it. Be it. My millennial brothers and sisters aged 24 to 39. My Generation X, my Gen X brothers and sisters aged 40 to 55. My baby boomer brothers and sisters aged 56 to 70. And most importantly, my seniors aged 71 to 121. There's no reason why you can't live to 121. Right now there's some person that's 116 and she's riding a bicycle every day. No reason. She has a good attitude and that's what our promotion's all about. In fact, I think I'm gonna sweeten the pot on that because I'm getting upset. Okay, and most importantly, the kids. It's all about the kids. From that infinite moment when he or she popped out of mommy's tummy to age 23, it's all about the kids. My kids, my grandkids, your kids, your grandkids, your great, great, great kids, because you know what? All kids are great. All kids that pop out of their mommy's belly are great. They're not tainted. They're loving. They're happy. They laugh. They live. They love. They laugh. They just, do you ever hear that expression, the laughter of a child? Laugh like a child? Because it's a cherubic sentience. Guys, we gotta catch our kids before it's too late. Because if we don't, then we're doomed as a civilization. 2.5 million. These kids are growing up to be bipolar, manic, depressive. Why? Because their parents were, and their parents were. We've got to break the chain. Break the bond of hatred, of bigotry, of racism, of manic, depressive, bipolar, type 2 disorder, disease. The time has come. We shall overcome today. 2.5 million kids in the United States of America, the greatest country in the history of civilization, but still we have 2.5 million kids that are living homeless. They're living in poverty. For all you folks out there that have a little cherubic little boy and girl that's waking up right now and going to school, picture that child being homeless on the street, sucking garbage from a toilet, eating cat food. And you know what's the most indignity of them all? And it's tough for me to say this. These are all facts. I only deal with facts, statistics. 20,000 children. 20,000 children in America today, because their parents are drug addicts, alcoholics, in utter despair and poverty, they have sold their children to the sex slave network. We have 20,000 children today that are under the age of 12 that are sex slaves in America today. Six-year-old boys and girls are being violated. They're being raped in the name of the mighty dollar. Hey, Miss Clinton. Hey, Mr. Trump. Why don't you talk about the real important thing? Why don't you talk about the really, really important issue today? Our kids. Talk about that 20,000 kids that are living in it, that are being violated at 6 and 7 years and 8 years old. Talk about how we got to rid that evil, that disgusting, despising evil from this country. Talk about the 2.5 million little boys and girls that are living in utter poverty, that are homeless. Get rid of that. Hold out on putting another dollar in the F-35. Hold out about putting another dollar in Halliburton's pocket for the Iraqi war. Hold off on it. Feed the homeless. Feed the 2.5 million kids that are starving today, that are going to turn out to be a blemish on our society. When they're 20 and 21 and 22 and 23, and you talk about, oh, we're, our taxes are too high, and we're looking at all these homeless, it's disgusting. And well, it's because of you. Take responsibility. Start being the champion that you were created to be. Take care of your kids today, because in 15 years from now, we'll have a better society. It's time. It's time we take back America. For our children's children, and for our children's children's children. There is still hope. There is still hope. Because you know what? There's hope in the Pope. On 3/13/13, Pope Francis became the leader of the church, and it's the largest organization in the world. It's 2.3 billion people, I believe. And you know something? This guy's a cool guy. People can change. It's about praising and forgiving and complimenting and inspiring. He just came out yesterday and said, "We as a church must forgive and must apologize to the gay people." This is amazing. After 2,000 years, I'm walking around saying the church is dead. Frankly, the church is dead. There's not one millennial that goes to church today. And Pope Francis knows that. Is there hope? Yeah, there's hope in the Pope. I don't know if it's going to survive, because there is no kid that goes to church. They don't want to go to see a priest, a reverend who's raping 8-year-olds in the back room. Why would they want to hear from him? Okay, that's enough, God. Don't be. Okay, you know what? We're going to end this with a song. Are you ready? Are you ready? Whew.
she was lost
in so many different ways, out in the darkness with no God. I know the cost of a losing hand, never thought the grace of God. Found the heaven on earth, you are my last, my first. And then I hear this voice inside. How could the silence be so loud? But I still go home, knowing that I've got you. It's only yours when the lights go down. My heaven on earth, you are my hunger, my thirst. I know. Keep the lights on for me and for you, for your children, for your mom, your dad, for your cousins, for your aunts, for your uncles, for your friends near and far, for your strangers, for Gar, for complete and perfect strangers. Make every day Father's Day. Make every day Mother's Day. I call it Baba Day. Turn to somebody, anybody. Turn to that street person, that homeless person that you see every day, hopeless, helpless, and give them a smile. Give them a hug. Just give them some good feeling. That's all they're looking for. Turn their life around. You turn someone's life around, it'll turn your life around. Keep the lights on. May the light of your soul always shine upon you. May the light shine upon you, my children, your neighbor, my country, my planet, you, my family. We are the silent majority no more. Namaskar. It's time for a right thoughts, right speech, and right heart. God bless you.